Okay, let's start. Let's pray. Father in heaven, thank you for the opportunity to learn. Forgive us my sins. Please give us wisdom and understanding for our love as we learn our lesson. We totally depend on you. Please bless my students with wisdom and understanding. Thank you for hearing our prayers. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Do you know how to make a login? Login, log out. Okay, very good. Hindi ko alam kung ano ginagamit ng... Do you use a PHP session or cookie? Cookie. Hindi ko alam yung sa... I don't know the Laravel style. I just know the manual style. So the idea is you have a list of users, you have a list of encrypted passwords. The password, you store it encrypted in the database, and you authenticate, and then you check for a cookie. So when the user visits your website, you look for the cookie. If there's no cookie, you redirect them to login page. If there's a cookie, you check if the cookie is in the database, which session. So you have a table of sessions, of the sessions, and if the user has a cookie, you look in the sessions if that cookie is there, and if it's still valid, if it's still logged in. If not, you give the user a new login, and optionally you can log the failed cookie. So when the user gets a new login page, when the user enters the username and the password, it will submit, and you check if you encrypt the username and the password, and you check it against the encrypted username and password in your user's database. If it matches, then you mark the session. Oh, by the way, you have to give a session ID cookie. You mark that session as logged in from here, and IP address, and put it in the sessions table. When somebody visits a page that is secure, that page checks the cookie and then checks from the database. And if the URL is correct and the time is correct and the cookie is correct, then you continue using that, you continue with that user in that app. If the cookie clicks log out, you log out the, you can mark that cookie as logged out or invalidated in the table of sessions. So there's another simpler way to do it. It's called HTTP password. But nobody's using that now because it's just very old technology. Now everybody's using cookie. Furthermore, for simple databases like that, you just need a username and a password. And it assumes that you only have one website or one app. But in complicated websites, you have many apps, right? And many roles, and you may have groups, and so on. So you have teachers, you have students, you have office workers, you have DSF people, you have RRU, and you may have user groups. And the application's access can be per individual or per group. So those are the other technologies that we're using. If you copy what Google is doing, the uniqueness of Google is that they can allow many different accounts to be logged in. I think in Facebook you can also allow many different accounts to be logged in, but you cannot use different accounts at the same time, diba? So Google, even if you have two Gmail accounts, they can both work, diba? Different tabs. In Facebook, when you shift to the other profile, all your tabs shift to the other profile, diba, diba? Diba sa Facebook? Pag nag-shift profile ka, lahat ng tabs mo shift profile. So Google's Google security is more advanced than Facebook. So we will try to make a simple one. We are going to create a table, users, user ID, and username, text, encrypted password text. Ano pa? Ano bang ginagawa dito? So, okay, we have one user, WinGP, and the password is encrypted using the MD5 hash, MD5 checksum, and I'm just concatenating the username with the password. The password is A. And this is the encrypted password. And then, yeah. So let's go to dorm. Anong dorm sa to? Well, let's create another. Let's create another table called sessions. User ID, int or session ID. Session ID is serial. User ID is int start time is timestamp, and end time timestamp. What else? Never mind the other things. What are we going to call it? In Iolis, I call it our session. Maybe we will call it, what do you want to call it? IT session. Let's call it AUP session. AUP IT session. Let's put up tapos if session we have to check in the database else show login. Then we have a function here. We're going to show login and die. Function show login. So this one should, we should generate a session here. How do we generate a session in Unit? Unique ID, PHP unique ID, okay. Thank you.
Okay,
Okay, without thinking. Let us add this author in our list and see if there's any problem. I'm supposed to just include. Let's see the errors. Author 95. Let me see the error. Unexpected semicolon. Period. Okay, this one. Six. 931. Able to connect to Postgres. Thank you. Thank you.
argument number three must be filled in from this result set. Argument number three. Need to resolve the rest of my way. Nag-log out tayo. Update session. Log out. When we try to log in. So, in the last 3 minutes, I made this author.php, which takes care of logging in, checking if the cookie is there, and logging out, and showing us who is the user, giving us key, giving us sessions, selecting from user. So there are two tables, select asterisk from users, select asterisk from sessions. This is the session I log out, this session I'm using. So how do you secure the PHP? Very easy, my friends, if you design it properly. So if you look at list.php, I just added this one line. So this is how I make programs. I first make the program without security, and then I add the security later, because to make it run and then secure it. How do I secure? If we already made the security module, like how we just did, I'm just adding one line on top of the PHP, and it will require a password na, di ba? So I just have to add this line. Actually, I just have to put include author.php. For example, sit. So in add doesn't write to the database. I only want to put a security on the PHPs that connect to the database. So in add submit, lagyan lang natin lahat. Oh, you know what? Okay. I can just pick who add that PHP, and then I just put PHP include author.php. Yan, secure na rin yan. So class, pag may nagpindot dito ng add, ganyan. Pero pag hindi siya nakalagin, tingnan niya. If I click add here, ito yung pang-add. If I reload, yan, okay siya. Pag nilog out ko itong sa kabila, tapos nireload ko ito, log in na rin siya. Kasi nag-log out na din sa kabila. Di ba? So the cookie that we are, binabantayan natin cookie ay nandito. This is how you will see and help troubleshoot the cookie. If you see here in the developer console, the cookie, you will see AUP IT session, and then our cookie is here. If we delete this one, wala lang. Ganyan pa rin, login pa rin. Yan. If we log in with incorrect password, wala lang. It will just give us a new cookie. If you log in with correct password, then this cookie is also is validated na, di ba? So here in add, pagpunta mo dito sa add, gumagana na rin yung add, di ba? Di ba? Ngayon, if you lose your cookie, ano ba, dililit ko to. When I reload this one, I don't have cookie, so it will ask for login again. Diba, diba? So, if we need to secure, so what we need to do is just add this line, author, on all the PHPs. Pico add submit that PHP, I'll just add here, include author.php, secure na yan. And then, saan pa? Pico delete. Ang kailangan ng security itong mga these files that tinker with the database. Okay, so what else? Pico edit. We're just gonna put here include author.php. This is going to PHP and coming back to HTML mode. And include edit submit. We just put here include author.php. And what else is here? List index pictures, nothing else. Index is the same as list, really? Okay, so we have a simple security. The password is A. Now the whole thing still supposed to work. Adding, let's try to add. See, add, edit. Okay, edit is there, delete. Delete is there. So, log out. Yan, ganyan. Hindi na siya makaano. So, this is the code. Final code. Since you only like to have the final code. For a simple login. Simple login. Only one app. The other things that I discussed, maybe is later, or you can just think of it for yourself. Where you can have many apps, same login, many apps, and different sessions, like how Google works. And you can log out each session individually, or you can log out all of the sessions. And ano pa nga yung gusto ko? And like groups, because if you have 500 users, and you try to manage all of the security of all of them, it's better to just group them. These people are from RAO. These people are from DSF. These people are from accounting. These people are from cashier. So if you have one new cashier, you don't manually click all the apps that the cashier is using. You just have a group for cashiers, and you get the you give the permissions for all of those cashiers. And when you change the permission of the group, they also change permission. Okay, I hope that this helps a little bit. Security is one of the most difficult things to design, because you have to think like a hacker. You have to think like a sysad, you have to think like a database guy, and also the architecture and the cookies and the redirects and the conditions and the possible holes. It is time already. Bye bye.